Welcome to my holiday card series. This is day number 12, and I'm starting out with a standard size card, and it's out of craft cardstock. This craft cardstock is from Stampin' Up, and I'm also going to be using a stamp set from Mickey Memories. This is from their Fall of Law collection. I believe the collection came out last year. And I've got some Seven Gypsies pattern tape here as well. I'm not going to be using the tape right away, but you'll see it coming up in a minute. I have some Baja Breeze cardstock that I'm punching out the edge with a Fiskars Scallop Sentiment Edge Punch. And then I'll be adhering it onto this cream cardstock that I previously cut to the size that I wanted. Just going to be adhering it to the very bottom. And then I'm taking the pattern tape and I'm applying it to some cream cardstock. And that's because this really is like masking tape, and it's pretty thin, and you can see the color underneath coming through. And I didn't want it to show through. I wanted that like cream yellow color to be there. So I just put it on some white cardstock and then cut it down. Now I'm using the Merry Christmas stamp in that Mickey Memory stamp set. And originally, what drew me to this stamp set was this font that they used for Merry Christmas. I thought it was really pretty, and I've always loved this font. So I really wanted that stamp set. Now I'm adhering the pattern tape piece to the centerpiece for the card. I just used some stamp dimensionals for that. And then I'll be rounding the corners with the We Are Memory Keepers Corner Chomper Punch. I'm using the half-inch corner punch on this particular card, but that corner chomper actually has two different sizes. It has a half-inch and a quarter-inch, and it's a really great tool to have on hand. These are some Sassafras buttons. This is their Blue in a Stitch button pack. Just using the white buttons from it. And now I'm going to be taking the snowflake from that Mickey Memory stamp set, and I'm going to be stamping it in kind of a repeated pattern around the edges with some Versa marking. And that's because I'm going to be doing some embossing. And I only went around the edges because I'm going to put that piece in the center, and it's going to cover everything up. So I didn't want to waste ink or embossing powder on something that was going to be covered up completely. So now I'm sprinkling on some embossing powder, and this is American Crafts embossing powder. It's just clear. And the way you know that it's melted and ready to go is there's a couple different ways. One, the color will change on this clear embossing powder, and also it gets kind of a glossy sheen to it. Most embossing powders will do that. And that's how you know that it's been heated enough and melted. Just adhering the center piece onto the card. And that pretty much finishes up the card for today. Hope you enjoyed it, and please come back and join me for day 13 tomorrow. Thanks for watching again, and I'll see you guys later.